Geese get a bad rap for being ornery and attacking children and whatnot, but the barheaded goose is actually a pretty laid-back species that makes an incredible journey over the Himalayas, going up in altitudes of 26,000 feet. To learn more about what is physiologically happening in the bodies of these geese, researchers strapped backpacks on them and gave them face masks and put them in a wind tunnel. To learn more, we sat down with a scientist who worked on the study.
I'm Julia York. I'm currently a PhD candidate at the University of Texas at Austin.
And can you walk us through how you raised these geese from birth and how you prepared them for this experiment?
We wanted to train these geese to fly in a wind tunnel so that we could manipulate them experimentally and measure their metabolic rate in a controlled environment. And we wanted the geese to be as calm and comfortable as possible under these conditions. So we raised the geese from eggs and spent every day with them for a whole summer, going for walks and taking naps and going for swims and eating lettuce. And so they thought we were their mom and that they were comfortable around us and we could get them trained on the experimental equipment.
And walk us through that experimental setup here. How was the wind tunnel arranged? How were the geese kept comfortable? All that sort of stuff.
So it's actually a wind tunnel that is designed for cars, but it was large enough that we could fly goose in it. We set it up with tubes that attach to a mask that we built to fit the geese, a little plastic mask, and measure the oxygen that they were consuming and the CO2 that they were producing, and then introduce nitrogen into the air that they were breathing to reduce the relative amount of oxygen in each breath and simulate altitude.
And I also understand that they're wearing backpacks.
So they have these little backpacks on that strap around their wings, and those held the heart rate monitors primarily, but also we did a subset of experiments where we tested the amount of oxygen and the temperature of their blood. And while we were doing those experiments, the backpacks also held those monitors.
Can you walk us through some potential challenges here? I imagine there were a few of them, training geese to fly calmly in a wind tunnel with a mask and a backpack on.
Geese are not food-motivated animals like dogs. You can't give them a treat to reward them for their behavior. They kind of do what they want to do. So when we first brought them into the wind tunnel, obviously we started them off very slowly, just getting them used to the environment, comfortable in that setting. And then we started turning on the wind tunnel so they could feel the air moving and the noise. And then we started allowing them to fly with the air running without the equipment, sort of like a treadmill, but for flying. And some of the geese just did not get it and would fly maybe for a minute, but then land and sort of sit there and wait for it to be over. So out of 19 total geese that we tried to train, we got 7 to fly consistently in the wind tunnel. And those geese would fly 1 good long flight per day.
And what were you finding as these geese were flapping around in the wind tunnel?
The 3 major things we found were that they were able to minimize their metabolic rate in low oxygen conditions. So either they were able to fly more efficiently or reduce unnecessary metabolic processes. We can't really differentiate between those 2 hypotheses. The second thing we found was that their heart rate didn't change between high and low oxygen conditions. That tells us that that increase in heart rate in the wild is due to some other component of altitude rather than the low oxygen. And the third thing we found was that they were able to drop their blood temperature as it goes towards the lung during the flight, hypothesized to increase the amount of oxygen that they're able to deliver to the muscle.
Physiologically, what is different about these geese that allows them to survive at such high altitude?
I mean, not only do they survive, right? They do this amazing migration where they go from sea level in India all the way up to the passes in the Himalayas without stopping in 8 to 12 hours. They breathe more deeply, which is a more effective way to breathe. And then they have larger lungs for their body size, so they can increase the oxygen extraction from every breath. They are able to increase their stroke volume, which is the amount of blood pumped per heartbeat, and they have hemoglobin in their blood that binds oxygen more tightly than other birds. So there's just a large suite of adaptations that make these birds able to do this migration.
Bringing this around to humans, because we're selfish, how about these findings tell us about how humans experience altitude sickness and potentially how we might be able to treat that by learning more about how geese deal with these things?
in mammals, we will increase our breathing, our rate of breathing in response to low oxygen, which reduces the amount of CO2 in our blood. In the geese, they have a lot of adaptations across, all the way from the way they breathe down to the mitochondria at the muscle that optimize the way they use oxygen. For example, their blood vessels in their brain are not sensitive to CO2, and so they don't get cerebral edema in the same way that we do. They don't get altitude sickness because of that. We understand what our responses are to these situations, and by studying animals that are adapted to these low oxygen conditions, what can we learn from that and bring that into medicine or high altitude or any of the things that humans struggle to do in these conditions.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much for your interest in the geese.